In our modern, civilized society, where we can get practically anything we want on a whim, it's hard to imagine a world of fear, death, and oppression. A world where your life could end without a moment's notice. But this was the world of less than 100 years ago. This was the world of the early 20th century. This part of this map here is Austria-Hungary. Austria-Hungary was a powerful empire in the middle of Europe in the early 20th century. On its southeastern border was this country, Serbia. And although things were tense between the two nations, not much would have happened between them had it not been for this small part of Austria-Hungary down here. Bosnia. Bosnia was part of Austria-Hungary. There were thousands of Serbs living in Bosnia. And all the Serbs wanted to join to become one independent nation. Now, of course, Austria-Hungary didn't want to let them do this. Because if it let Bosnia free, it would have to let the rest of its empire free. And that would break up all of its power.
On the 28th of June, 1914, Archduke Franz Ferdinand, the heir to the Austro-Hungarian throne, and his wife, Sophie, were travelling through Sarajevo, the capital of Bosnia. They knew about terrorist activities by Serbian nationalists in the area, but went there nonetheless. As they were travelling by the river Miljaka, Nedeljko Kabrunovic, one of a group of 6 Serbian nationalists planning to kill the Archduke, threw a bomb at the car. Franz Ferdinand skillfully deflected the bomb, causing it to explode underneath the car behind him, rendering that car unusable. Ferdinand's driver drove off down the road in order to evade further assassination attempts. However, the driver got stuck and started to turn the car around. A young man, Gavrilo Princip, a member of the assassination group, was standing nearby. He walked slowly up to the car and shot both Franz Ferdinand and Sophie before being arrested.
This assassination led to a war between Austria-Hungary and Serbia. Now this alone would not have started a world war had it not been for the complex series of alliances that interlinked the great powers of the world at the time. The idea behind these was simple. If I'm allied with so-and-so, nobody would dare attack me. Of course, when two countries such as Serbia and Austria-Hungary went to war, this dragged more and more and more of the major powers of Europe and later the world into the conflict, thus creating the First World War.
Most people thought that the war would be over by Christmas 1914. It wasn't. consisted of around 4 years' worth of bitter battles. Arguably, one of the worst battles of World War I was the Battle of the Somme. On the first day, the 1st of July 1916, alone, the British Army suffered 57,470 casualties, including 19,240 dead. This was, and still is, the bloodiest day in the history of the British Army.
Was it really such a massacre for the British soldiers? Well, here's what one of the few people who survived the battle says about it.
There was frustration. We'd lost so many people, and taken so little ground. And men began to wonder, why? There was no feeling of giving up. They were just wondering, why? And when you came out into the billets, you saw these endless lines of walking wounded and ambulances, and we wondered how long we could exist.
Field Marshal Douglas Haig was the man in charge of the battle plans for the Battle of the Somme. His plans involved bombing German trenches for a week with shell fire until they were so totally obliterated that his men could simply walk slowly across no man's land and kill the survivors in hand-to-hand combat. Needless to say, it didn't work.
Fire!
But why would such a plan fail? Well, I went to visit some of the German trenches on Vimy Ridge to find out. The barrage of shells was incredibly powerful. Behind me you can see the great damage that just one shell did with this crater. It's pretty big.